All right, y'all. This is what we got. A new shower overlay and everything. All the way up to the ceiling. They did a very good job. Even got the curved shower rod up there. Looks really good, man. There's only one thing that I don't even know if you can see it from here. The issue that we're having is with the way this wall is cut. Up here is cut really good. And I don't know if you can see it, but when you get right around in here, it starts to change along the edge. Look at the edge up here. As you can see, when you're looking at the side there, you can see the side real good. But as soon as you start to get down here, you can't see the side. And I'm standing right here at the corner of it. You can see it up here, the side here, but you can't see the side here. All the way down, you can barely see the side. Look at her. We'll just pass it up and down. And you look at the edge. As you look at the edge of it, I'm not moving the camera, I'm staying right. Basically, you can see the side there. Now, this piece has been cut, it's been measured, and it's been cut. But somehow, it's a whole piece from the ceiling all the way down to the tub and around to the floor. It's one piece. And what the problem is, and I'll show you. We look up here. Let's look up here. It's nice and flush right in here. Nice and flush. Nice and flush. But look. Oh, look, there's a little separation. And as we keep going down, it gets bigger. The separation gets bigger from the wall all the way down. Look at that. Now, this is the issue right here with these installers that installed this. They cut, they measured and cut this piece here. This is the issue we're having with it not conforming to the wall like it is up top. When you get down here, you got this big gap. Now, they're saying that it's the wall, the way the wall is, that they cannot cut this right. Or the way the wall is basically their reason. I'm sorry, but I just can't go with that. That doesn't make any sense to me. no matter how the wall is shaped, if you're measuring and cutting a piece, you should be able to measure and cut it to the way the wall is, if your measurements are right. It looks to me that this is measured and cut wrong. And this is the issue we're having. These guys, they're sticking with it's the wall theory. Now, this tub, it was tiled, and I wish I took pictures before they did this, but on this side of the wall, it was tiled from about, I don't know, maybe about up here or so, or down here, I can't remember where, but it stopped at a certain point. It stopped at a certain point and came all the way down to the floor. Even down here, it was right to the edge of the wall. Down here, it's to the edge of the wall. And the contractors who did the tiling didn't have this problem with the wall. They brought that tile all the way to the edge of the wall. There was no overlapping of the tile from the wall like it is with this piece of whatever this material is. Like this is overlapping it. I mean, come on, man. This is they just, to me, you know, they just cut this piece wrong. But the tile went all the way to the floor. On top of that, you have this piece. Look at here. You have this piece on the outside of the molding. And we know down here, of course, it's not going to conform to the wall because you got that right there. That's as far as it's going to go. You know what I'm saying? It's not going to conform to the wall. To me, I believe this piece is just cut wrong. They cut it. They measured it. They cut it wrong. And their thing is it's the wall. So I'm sorry. I just can't go with that. That don't even make sense to me right there. It's the wall, you know. But what we're having them do is come back, and what they're gonna do is cut it. I guess along here. I don't know. Maybe somewhere along in here, all the way down, and put a piece on the edge here. And I'm hoping that they're gonna cut it all the way to the floor. You know, we'll see how that goes. But you can see just looking at it right here. Look down there. It kind of curves out. You know. So, I mean, they're going to cut it somewhere in here, all the way down. Put a piece here, where this piece here will be flush with the wall. I mean, how are you going to cut something and have this enormous gap? It's not even flush to the wall. How you gonna measure and cut something like that? And then say it's the wall. What is that, man? Come on, man. I seen some some real work in my day, and just never seen. I seen some contractors do some real stuff, man. And I mean, I work in the construction industry, basically. I'm around that stuff all day long. When I'm looking at these new houses that's going in, I'm in that action. I'm a part of that process from the foundation, from the footings to the end, to the roof of the house. I'm involved in the process. I see it from the beginning to the end, and I never seen no mess like this. This wall could be curved like a Disney house, like a wall in a Disney house or something. And I seen contractors be able to cut, measure and cut better than this right here. I mean, that where I work, the town of Apex, there is an actual house in Apex that looks exactly like a house from off of Disneyland, with all the curves and whatnot that they have at that house. Them contractors cut and finished excellent. I mean, there was nothing like this right here. But somehow it's the wall. Look at that gap. Come on, man. That's the issue right there. Right there, that gap. Look at that. See that? I can stick my finger all the way in there. Look at that. All the way in. That's my finger right there. Hopefully, they'll be able to fix this for $3,000, a little over $3,000. This is what you get, really. This joint, this right here, costs $3,000, a little over $3,000 to do, and this is what they leave us right here, $3,000. I expect a better job for $3,000 right there. All right. Peace.